Hello, my dear students. I hope you all are doing well. So, today I am going to start the next topic, that is characteristics of land. Now, before starting this characteristics of land, I just want to highlight the things which we have discussed in the previous video. So, in the previous video, we have discussed about the different factors of reduction. We have done the definition also. So, what were the different factors of reduction? Land, labor, capital, and organization. So, today we are going to discuss the definition of land and the characteristics of land. So now, how to define land? So in economics, land includes all the free gifts of nature, or the things which is provided by nature are included in the definition of land. So what are that free gifts of nature? The free gifts of nature includes forest resources, mineral resources, mountains, maybe water, sunlight, etc. So these all are the things provided by our nature. So this is included in a land. Okay, so the first characteristic, now we are moving towards the characteristics. So the first characteristics, we have free gifts of nature. As I said, the different mineral sources, okay, surface of that earth, maybe water, sunlight, these all are the free gifts of nature, and man has to spend nothing to obtain it. Okay, so these all are the things which is provided by our nature free of cost. That's why it is called free gifts of nature. Why it is free gifts of nature? Because man has to spend nothing to obtain it. Simple. That's why it is called free gifts of nature. And what are that free gifts of nature? That includes sunlight, water, mineral resources, okay, forest resources. These all are the example. Okay, so the second characteristics we have, land is limited in supply. Means the supply of land is fixed. If we see the other items or the other factors of production, that can be increased over a period of time. But the supply of land will remain same as it is, because we cannot increase the size of land. Whatever the land, it is provided by our nature, that will remain fixed. If we take the example of other factors of production like labor or machinery equipments, we can say that one as a capital. So that capital and the labor can be increased over time. For example, if the population of a country increases, or if the population of a world increases, obviously the number of labor force may increase. Similarly, if the number of industries, factories in worldwide, suppose it increases, the number of production of machinery, equipments, tools, etc. may be increased, but the supply of land cannot be increased. The supply of land will remain fixed. Okay, so third characteristics we have, land is a primary factor of production. So why land is called primary factors of production? This is the peculiar characteristics of land, because we have to make use of land to produce anything, or for any other factors of production to be used, land is important. We have to use other factors of production on land, then only the production may take place. I will give you one example. For example, in order to construct industry, okay, or factory, what is needed? Land is needed. Land is needed to construct that factory. Similarly, if you want to make use of that land for agricultural purpose or for the production of any food grains, without land, it is not possible to produce any food grains. So that's why it is called primary factors of production. Means we have to make use of this land in order to produce, or in order to produce any items, we have to make use of this land. That's why it is called primary factors of production. Next characteristics we have, land is a passive factors of production. Why it is called passive factors of production? Land is a passive factors of production because land cannot produce by itself. Okay, in order to produce anything on that land, at least the services of labor and the capital is required. Without the help of labor or machinery, we will not be able to produce on that land. So land cannot produce by itself. In a simple way, we can say that land cannot produce by itself. In order to produce anything on that land, the services of labor, maybe the services of capital, etc. is required. Okay, next important characteristics we have, land is immovable. Immovable means not possible to shift from one place to another, or not possible to transport from one place to another place. I'll give you a few example. The land of Delhi cannot be shifted to Kolkata, or it cannot be transported to Kolkata. So here what we can see that the land is a immovable factors of production. If you see in the case of other factors of production like labor and the capital or the machinery equipments, that is possible to some extent, that is possible to shift from one place to another place. I'll give you example how is it possible to shift from one place to another place. Suppose say one labor is there, and if that labor is working in a vacuum and he is getting, suppose say, 200 rupees per day, and the same labor if he move from Pakim to, suppose say, Gangtok, and he is getting rupees 500 wages. So what will do that? He will move from that Pakim to Gangtok because higher wages, he is getting higher wages, and that higher wages will attract him to move or shift from one place to another place. Similarly, machinery, equipments, tools can be also shifted from one place to another place. But in the case of land, it is not possible. The land of Pakyong cannot be shifted to Gangtok, or land of Pakyong cannot be shifted to Renok or Gezing or Namchi. Similarly, the land of or the soil surface of that Namchi cannot be shifted to Pakyong. That's why it is called immovable factors of production. Land is immovable factors of production. Okay, next important characteristic of land is that land has many uses. Means land have multiple uses, that land can be used for the several purposes. Even you know how the land can be used for the many purposes. I'll give you a few examples. That land can be used for the production of agricultural item or food items, vegetable, fruits, etc. Similarly, that land can be used for the construction of roads, railways, highways, buildings, factories, and so on. That's why the land has many uses. Land can be used for several purposes. Okay, that's why it is called many uses, and this is also one of the important characteristics of land. Now, next characteristics we have, land differs in location. So this is also very important point. We know that the land in Delhi, Kolkata, and other cities, okay, what will happen in that area? The land are scarce, okay, and because of that scarcity, because it will be, the cities will be highly populated, number of factories will be more, number of shops, and the economic activity will be more, and that's why the value of land will be very high in especially cities area. Similarly, you can see that in the river valley side, the land, okay, land can be more fertile, and that land can be used for the agricultural purpose, for the production of various type of agricultural item. Even the location of land may be in the mountains area. So in mountains area, that land can be used for, it is not used, but it is used by the nature itself, and we can see that green areas, different sceneries, okay. So that land differs in location. That land may be present in the mountains area, cities, maybe in a plains area, and the purpose of that land may be different. Okay, so these all are the important characteristics of land. And sometimes in 8 marks question, the question may be asked to you. Define land, what are the characteristics of land? So if you define and if you explain this any 5 characteristics of land, that will be sufficient. So this question carries 7 marks or 8 marks, okay, and this is very important for your board exam.